Every single item is hand-drawn. From newspaper, all the packaging of the drinks, cigarette, even all the magazines. I don't 3D print, I don't use any machine assisted or whatever. Hello, I'm Wilfred. I'm 55 this year. I'm a full-time cardboard miniature artist. Actually started at a very young age, sort of like in primary school. Because we didn't come from a well family. So when I see other kids, they have nice toys and so on, then I'll go home, I'll try to make something for myself. I use paper. I think that is the very beginning of what I'm trying to do now. Okay, my artwork, basically 90% of them are made out of waste material. Carton boxes, waste paper, maybe recycled chopstick, even mooncake boxes and so on. I have worked on a lot of different scales. The smallest scale I work on is 1:200, which actually the houses look actually small. One of the first things I wanted to do, something in relation to me, which is actually my childhood, where my growing up was. That is the HDB, which I actually named as Racial Harmony. Last time, our lifestyle was very different. There's no gate. The place is small. It's just one bedroom kind of a flat. So most of a lot of activities, especially when you play and so on, it's all filled up at the corridor. Neighbors are just running around. I go to your house room to play, you go to mine. And sometimes we ask the elders for guide about homework and so on. So these are the things that I have tried to recall and I have put them into my miniature. I make my miniature mainly along this nostalgic line. Because for a lot of old stuff, what people refer to them mainly is through photographs. But I find photographs, it actually is more like a 2D. As a miniature, it is more like a 3D kind of thing. You can actually see the thing, not only for your eyes, it's onto your soul. So you can almost like walk through the place and then look at every item that are there and then all the memories that actually can be recollected there. Okay, one of my favorite projects until now, actually the most recent, the provision shop. Okay, I try to replicate my father-in-law's provision shop. Okay, this one I asked my wife to come along so she can give you a better brief of the history of the provision shop.
其实这个店面对我父亲非常有意义。爸爸其实经营了这个店面已经有44年，所以这个店铺其实是由爸爸妈妈还有哥哥一起经营的。 其实在这七年里面，我们失去了两个重要的人，就是哥哥跟妈妈。然后其实我们时常都有叫他退休，毕竟他也已经78岁了。所以对他来讲，其实他会很不舍得。所以当老公说要为我的爸爸做这个杂货店的时候，我讲其实也挺不错的。
It's one of my longest piece that I have done. On average, usually I complete a job about 2 weeks time. This one took me one whole month because I want to capture every single thing inside. Down to you can see those newspaper where you put to, you can see behind the back alley there, there's actually a packet of coffee hanging there. Because these are not only details of the shop, this is actually his habit. So that's where this little item that give him that kind of special feeling.
所以这个杂货店的模型，我觉得带给爸爸很多很多的回忆。因为毕竟在看到这个模型的时候，我想应该能让他勾起了不少的对哥哥和妈妈的回忆。当我们把这个作品呈现给他的时候，他看了过后其实是十分感动的。
My miniatures are actually our life. They are not just a small, common visual kind of artwork. When I do my miniature, I actually put in a lot of heart and soul into it. So everything I have to be handmade and as far as possible, as localized as possible. I read, do research about the era, the time, so that it can be kept and passed on to generations. I actually have something in mind, but I think I won't tell you here.